2, I guess. 16-4 in favor of Belarus. Belarus getting back on the horse and 1-1 now going into a decider. But that didn't seem like Belarus can bring it back, and even not with this much of a difference.
Yeah, but they were allowed basically to do whatever they want on the D side. Croatia, I think they got punished a few times. They tried to defend that A long, and for basically the second half of the first half of those two, they decided to not contest that A long at all. And the only response they had was boosting to short, but I mean, you need more than that. Try and push B with two guys. If they're gonna take A control, you need more map control. If they're gonna push A long, you need more map control than just short. I mean, yeah, that's a start, but you need more. And it was only one of the things that went wrong for Croatia on that CD side, winning only, what, 4 rounds.
Yeah.
They had a chance of a comeback. I think it was round 10 when they won that 2v5. It was Revi and Nix winning a 2v5, which was great for them. And in the next round, they had a chance to, get one more round. But Nix, I mean, spraying with an M4 from that distance, from A-long to the site, he had a nice, small play, throwing a flash. So the player, I think it was Fast or something like that, so he could think that Nix is coming from short, but he actually threw it from long. He surprised him, he outplayed him, but the shots weren't just connecting. And that was the round they got reset, and at that point it was already pretty great.
Yeah, that's why I wanted to say this is a game of reset for Croatia.
Yeah. I just hope they're going to miss a couple of more throws tonight after 3:30. I know that all Croatians know what I'm talking about, but stick to the CSGO, not basketball. Third map, we're getting into the third map. It will be Cobblestone. Decider, it will be Cobblestone or Nuke.
Nuke.
And Belarus decided, if I remember correctly,
yes,
to ban Nuke and leave Cobblestone. How do you feel about that?
Well, as far as I know, Giants really loved to play that Cobblestone. They had a pretty good showing on CS Adria. I think it was back in the day when they played a couple of tournaments as well. They really loved to play that Cobblestone, not just overpass as we saw. But I don't know if they're broken after this game, because maybe the game before that, overpass Belarus, yeah, they lost, but they lost in a close line, like 16-12. What was 16-12? Yeah.
Yep.
So you were right. And now getting stumped basically on Dust 2, winning 16-4. I didn't really expect them to play that much of a bad city side on Dust 2, but coming to Cobblestone, if they maybe start on city side and manage to get more than 6-7 rounds, I think it would be great for them. I think Nix really loves to play that Cobblestone Mario as well. As I said, they were in the same team, so maybe we'll see something different coming out of Croatia on Cobblestone. But it's really a really tough task winning this one.
Yes. The other hand, I wanna we bashed them after overpass, so I gotta give it up to Fast and Sashkin. They stepped up on this last two. It weren't just a Robo and Cyber Focus. Dobri, I think he's still kind of missing, but
he's not being Dobri.
But Fast and Sashkin, they played this Dust 2 really well, and you see the result there. So,
I just wanted to point that out. Belarus didn't change, didn't swap any players,
yeah,
and it paid off. Do you think they can all step up again in Cobblestone, or do you think Cyber Focus and Robo are going to be the ones who will carry?
Talking about Belarus, I agree that they stepped up, and I think they need to step up definitely on Cobblestone. But once again, I think CyberFocus was their best player, especially on that T side. He was getting pickoffs on mid. He was pushing short alone through some bad smokes from the CTs, getting pickoffs there. So CyberFocus, he's really doing his thing, carrying this team of Belarus. The only difference between Overpass and Dust2, he got help on that Dust 2 in a form of 3 at least, if not all 4 players. So I think they need somewhat of the same showing as they had on Dust 2 in order to win this Cobblestone.
Yeah, speaking about the bad smokes and stuff like that on Dust 2, a couple of times players from Croatia
missed throws. Yeah.
Okay, you can call that like that. But I wanted to speak about RB Furious. He comes to my mind first. He tried a couple of times to push through smoke without flash, even if Croatia was 4-on-4, 4-on-3, and he basically lost them that round because he was trying to do some individual plays that you really get punished from. Like you can't. Okay, maybe if you need at one point like one individual play that will win you the round, but if you get punished one time and you push through the smoke, don't do it second or third time without the flash or without the help of your teammates. And he tried again a couple of times to push that through that smoke, and Belarusian players always expected that and punished him. So at one point, I think it was 4-on-4, Stole. With the flank, I think he killed one guy on long. They were already going long and they were 4-on-4. Basically, you just wait for the plant and go out of that. Like, you know you have control of long. You can push with two players maybe from short, take control of short, one player from CT. You basically, if with good team play, you can have that round. But he decided to push through smoke. He gets punished, gets killed. And after they kill him, they don't worry about the city spawn. They go for a long kill Stole there, and you win the round easily because of the one stupid mistake, I would say. So they need to work a bit out of that. I think if he played with maybe different player or different team leader, I actually talked about that without audio technician, and if you had a leader like Casa,
audio technician knows CS:GO.
Yeah.
Wow.
Really.
Wow. I didn't know that.
So
I have to talk to the guy.
I talked.
If he knew CS:GO, he wouldn't be an audio technician.
Yeah, that I agree. Yeah.
We talked about like imagine having Casa as your in-game leader at that point.
I can imagine that.
Yeah,
I think I can. Okay.
So imagine him like.
Is
you
that okay? Why you're a host?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, that's why I'm not playing right now.
Yeah. So I think they need a bit hard hand in their leader. So yeah. He maybe yells at plays like that.
The Croatia won the ninth round, picked the CT side, just like you said it would be good for them. Starting on that CT side, your predictions?
Yeah, I'm afraid for Croatia now, because you know the mentality of the teams from these parts, from Balkans and so on, not many comebacks.
Yeah, especially losing one map,
that's known for Serbian teams too. And I just think that if they don't get a good start, it's going to go all downhill for them. So, I mean, I'm going to say 16-8, Belarus.
Okay.
Well, I'll actually stick with the neighbors. I want them to win, so I'll go 16-14 for them.
It's going to be a bye-bye for one country. We'll see if it's going to be Croatia or Belarus. Let's go live, Harry and Megaman. Go, go.
Thank you there for that introduction, and thank you all for tuning in as well. It is going to be the third map now, Belarus versus Croatia. I'm going to be your host, Harry, and of course I'm joined by my American friend, Mega Man. How's it going, buddy?
Yo, what up, dog? How you feeling, brother?
Every time, more and more over the top. It's great. I love it.
You got to do what you got to do, my friend. One-to-one series right now. I'm excited. We got some cobblestone hype, and we've got some action already. Is Croatia going to be able to pick up 3 kills, 4 kills now? Robo, the only one to answer, back at Cyber Focus. It's going to be their last man standing here for the CT side over there by the murder hole in the A bomb site. Sorry to cut you off there, Harry, but what you were saying wasn't nearly as important as what was happening on my screen.
That is very, very true indeed. That's normally the way of it. And yeah, Simon Focus there dropped like a, I don't know, like a mic, bam. And that does mean the first round goes the way of Croatia. So that's a good start for them. And I do agree with what one of the analysts was saying about how Croatia, they need to have a good start if they are to stand any chance of winning this, because their mentality would have been so bad after that previous game, and we were even seeing it in how they were playing, that a bad start would of course mean disaster. So if they manage to secure these first three rounds, I do expect to see some good things coming from them. And well, let's continue on into this. It's going to be a force by coming out from Belarus, Croatia. They're going to be on a fairly standard by 2 AKs, 3 MAC-10s, so a lot of potential here to farm some money. And well, it's looking like B is going to be the site of choice. There are 3 players here trying to counteract this, and Robo is going to be the first one trying to go for this peek onto a drop. Isn't going to be able to find anyone. He might have seen the head of next just then, but nothing too much is yet. Stole trying to open things up with a kill onto Sashkin, but unable to do so. And right now, things just very, very passive across the board. Croatia just biding their time. Belarus, they don't want to be peeking too aggressive. They want to use these pistols at close range where they're most effective. And, well, the push should be underway fairly shortly, but that bomb's going to be heading back over towards A, actually, when you look at it. So I think what they've done is they baited out a rotation here. If they find this kill on a Cyber Focus in mid, that's just going to open up that A site completely and leave it open to the taking from the Croatian side.
Look at the mass exodus coming out from the B-bomb side right now from the CT side. They're going to stack back over here towards A. Cyber Focus finds one in mid. He's going to relay that information. Bomb has been spotted. And now it's rotating back around towards the B-bomb site. So Dobry going to join his comrade over in the B site. You've got Sashkin playing from Chicken Coop. See what they can do. Nobody coming over towards the drop side. You're going to have a lot of players filtering in. 5-7 going to go to work. Finds one. Not able to find a second one. And now Sashkin's just got to bide his time. He's going to come out around the corner. Jumping MAC-10. Going to find him. Takes him down. Robo going to be your last man standing. Did salvage the MAC-10 that was dropped. He's going to be coming on the long flank, but that's Mariucci's territory. Actually going to double peek in. 9 HP. Does a lot of damage. Gets him very low, but he's not able to solidify any of the kills. And Croatia going to walk away with that one by the skin of their teeth. Do have a pause coming out from the Croatian side. So maybe another bit of latency issues. I don't see Nyx buying anything just yet. So maybe it's him this time around. Nope, he bought. Furious. I'm assuming it's... Nope, he's switching weapons. So it's not him. Maybe it's Mariucci again. Nope, he's moving around. So what the hell is going on?
Oh, there we go. Now it was. I don't know what just happened. But yeah, I little bit of a tech pause there for the Croatian side. Very, very quick. Very, very efficient. No one dropped out. It was all good. So Croatia, they're going to be starting things off in a very good way. Belarus onto an eco round this round. You've got the P250 on Dobry. So a little bit of a potential to do something here, but you know, not too much. Maybe a little bit of economic damage is all they can really hope for. Is the push from Croatia is going to be underway. Revy starts it off. Dobry does manage to get one. Nyx, though, comes in. Revy gets two, and it's all going to fall on Sashkin and Cyber Focus here for the retake. 2 versus 4. Sashkin does manage to actually pick up one, so they've done a good bit of economic damage so far. And with that bomb only just going down, there could still be time for them to put in a little bit more work and maybe even get this down to 2 players being left alive, which when you consider that they went into this with, you know, just a pistol, like vanilla pistols, it's been fairly good so far being able to take down 2 players.
Yeah, not bad. They've got 2 MAC-10s as well, so they can set up for some exit kills, but Sashkin's actually just going to get walled down there from Mariucci. Not giving a crap over in that area, just spams him up. And now it's Cyber Focus outside of this B hallway. If they do exit this direction, he's going to have an opportunity. And they are coming towards him. He might be able to find Furious. They're making a lot of noise. Nick's coming around in the front. Bide your time, Cyber Focus. Bide your time. Let them get close. Let that MAC-10 do the work. One of them extremely low. Finds one. Not able to get the second one, but he does manage to do a little bit more damage to the economy. As they have stacked up a lot of money on the Croatian side, they forced 3 rebuys. Revy's going to go into an UMP, Curious. Doesn't actually go for the AWP, doesn't go for the AK-47, so maybe expect him to go a little bit quicker towards drop room. I would assume to maybe try to put the armor pin in the close range of that SMG to work, and he's going over towards the stairs right now, so I half expect to see this play played out. It's almost like I watch CS for a living, bro, you know, just being able to call that.
I mean, looking at it as well, you got Mariucci. He's going to be watching that mid play, not allowing them to get any free information out of the Belarus side by doing any sort of, you know, unannounced pushes. That's not going to be allowed, and the rest of the Croatians are going to be able to towards that B site, just putting the pain on it in terms of grenades, trying to force the Belarusians out of position. And, well, Flash does go in, so the push could potentially be underway here. Revy's going to be going down drop, like you say. Fast does find one onto Furious out on A. Fast now Furious out onto the platform area. That's going to slow down that push as well, and it leaves Stolen in a position where he's all by himself, so he gets taken down there. There's going to be no one there to trade for him. You've got 2 players down in drop as well. Stolen is going to be able to take that fight, comes out on top as he picks one up onto Robo. Dobry on the other side of the smoke, and Revy's just across from him. They're almost touching the barrels of each other's guns, and he's going to get taken down. Revy falls. Dobry does secure a second as well. And well, 2 versus 4 now this round, looking like it could go the way of Belarus. Especially with this push from Fast, that's going to be Stolen. Mariucci both going down there, and 1-3 is going to be the scoreline, with Belarus securing their first round on the first rifle by the first half. Lots of firsts there, lots of them.
That was a really good looking round there from Belarus as well. They're able to completely lock that one down. Keep 4 players alive also. Cyber Focus, I believe, was the only casualty in that last round, and he's able to get the AWP back into his hands. Maybe he wasn't even the casualty. I wasn't really paying attention. It was actually Robo that was the one that died, so apologies for that. But again, with that being said, a fast push coming towards the B-bomb site. It's going to get negated by a smoke and a flash. All timed from that. Are you two over here in middle? Just looking for any extra pressure to come around from the side, but nothing doing just yet. Very slow play from the T side bomb all the way back in the B halls. Don't want to give away the extra positioning here. Sashkin at long A. He's hearing all of this noise in middle. So he's got a lot of information that there are a couple of players that are going to be over here towards mid. One player actually pushing up over towards the danger zone, danger stairs. And if they're not careful, they could potentially flank out Sashkin. He's got to be watching behind him right now. Stoll holding the angle. Sashkin going to be walking directly into this one. He's got to hit the shot. He's not going to be able to get it. Perfect positioning from Stoll. Burning one alive with the B-bomb sink. Great flashes come out. Counter flashes on point as well. Dobry going to be able to take down Mariucci. And now Robo on the A-bomb site. It's going to get tested. He might have gotten spotted. He did, but he wins the battle anyway.
Yeah, and that should get them the information they need to call the rotate in as he does discover. Stolen there over towards long as he gets taken down. That's me a 3-on-3. Cyberfocus getting one there to delay this push. Rebby and Nyx, though, coming in huge. Do manage to take down two Belarus players. And the Blink of Eyes are going to fall into Dobry, who does push through that smoke. Very aggressive. It does push off for him, though. It does play out for him, though, sorry, as he finds that kill on a Rebby. Now it's going to go 1-on-1. Bomb gets planted. 32 HP left alive on Nyx. And Nyx going for a very aggressive play here, and it pays off for him as Dobry gets taken down, and it's going to go 1-4 in favor of Croatia. Croatia looking very, very strong as they start on the T side of Cobblestone. And, you know, I do feel like Dust then was a little bit of a blip for them. It's something that, you know, I mean, they did terribly on Dust. Like, let's not sugarcoat that. They did not play how we'd seen them play in the first map or how we're seeing them play now. It was like a whole different team quickly subbed on in.
Yeah, they didn't look very good in that last map, but the big thing about that was a pretty spurious peek from Nyx there, going full aggression, jumping up on top of that mid roof, or on top of that A roof, and that was, you know, this is Nico round, it's not really that important, they're getting slaughtered over the B bomb site, and the bomb is going to go down, so I have no problem talking about the previous round here, and that was, I mean, a 1v1, Nyx only had like 34 HP, and he jumps up on top. That was a very aggressive play, very risky as well. He could have easily lost his life there and lost the round for his team. But he does manage to land the shot. Robo's going to be able to find one. These SMGs just shredding the CT forces. Robo does manage to pick up a Molotov and a SMG of his own. Looking to put a little extra cheddar in the bank, and he does manage to take down Furious, so doing a little bit of damage here. Comes out in front of the APC, trying to find one on the Revy, not able to get it done. Finally swarmed upon. Two kills from Stolitz. $1,200 for him and $600 for Mariucci as well as Revy. They're going to launch into this next round with a 5-1 scoreline lead. So again, right back into the action. It's going to be the buy up here from the CT side of Belarus. They've got to get something going. This AWP from CyberFocus has been relatively quiet. FAMAS in the hands of the CT side as well. Oh, and that is a very costly miss there. Revy's going to be able to get the AWP out of his hands. Sashkin going to be able to find one, but the retort comes immediately from Furious as he takes down Fast. Hilariously enough, it is going to be a man advantage here for the Croatian side. Stoll losing his life over at the B-bomb site. Revy with the AWP does find Dobry. Now they got to be very careful. Sashkin's kind of boxed in here in middle. He loses the battle there with Mariucci. Even though he had the bomb down, it's a 3-on-1. Robo is going to be able to get himself out in front of the smoke in mid. Potentially try to line up some of these players as smoke goes out towards A, but the retreat is coming back in towards B because they have full site control on that B bomb site. Furious has got so much real estate to work with right now. There's not going to be very much room to move as far as Robo is concerned. So this is going to look like another round here for the Croatian side. And at what point do you decide to take a pause here? It's going to be 6-1. Robo's got no chance to recover into this round. He's going to fall back in towards the bottom side of mid. Actually gets a silenced M4 instead of the A4. Looking for the AWP at long. Not going to find anything there. Revy already stole it. And now he just tries to hang onto this rifle for the next round. Very tough situation to be in. 6-1 will be the scoreline when this round expires. Croatia looking very good here on Cobblestone. So far.
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, securing this sixth round for them does put them 5 rounds ahead. And when you look at the economy of Belarus as well, it is going to be in complete and utter tatters after losing this round. Should mean Croatia can take this 1-7 fairly comfortably, and at that point, you know, you're at kind of this position where unless Belarus are able to rectify these issues and get on top of them, Croatia have the potential to run away with it because they're building up such a strong economy, they're building up, you know, so much momentum and so much emotional courage and vim and vigor for their side that, you know, they don't really have to worry about a few minor setbacks. It's just the issue is we have seen Croatia and Belarus both are quite emotional teams when it comes down to it. I don't mean that they cry a lot. I don't mean, you know, that their acting's any good. I just mean, you know, emotions do play a huge role in Counter-Strike, and some teams are more prone to it than others. And I think both of these teams are fairly prone to it. So whatever team does kind of start to fall behind, start to be put at a disadvantage, they're the ones that are going to suffer the most from that.
Yeah, that's the big thing about it. Belarus taking a moment here to cool their heads before they go into this next round. Robo with the only rifle. I expect, yeah, they're going to send all five players over towards B. This is going to be the smart call, or at least CyberFocus is going to play the fast rotator from the double doors outside of the CT spawn. Fast push from the terror side in towards the B bomb site. Only one to try to lock this one down. Flashbang on point, going to blind him up a little bit, but he is going to be able to win that initial duel. Players come in towards the drop room. Dobry is going to be able to find one. The M4 paying dividends for him. There's only one man left. Revy lost all of his teammates. He's only got the UMP to work with as well.
Yeah, I do feel there was a little bit of overconfidence there from the Croatian side as they go onto that site. And well, Revy's going to push in and does get punished for that as two players are there to peek him in return. So it's going to go 2-6. Belarus, they secure a second round on the board. And at this point, this could be the sort of impact they needed. This is the time they needed to happen as well. And a very, very efficient and good uses of the pause there from the Belarusian side. Because normally, I feel like they wait too late. But I mean, Belarus, they could tell there was a problem. They know that they needed to fix it. And they caused called the pause in, at a time where, you know, it's not too late. You know, there's still plenty of time for them to get on top of it. And hopefully, with that pause, this could be a turnaround for them. We might see them start to string a few more rounds together.
Yeah, that's exactly what they need. They need to start stringing these together. They need to start doing some work here. CyberFocus has been quiet with the AWP into this matchup. Forward position from Revy. Could get naded out here or spammed up through the smoke. You can see they're trying to line that one up. But he is tucked around that little pillar. Not going to be able to find him just yet. Spread out on the terrace side. Harassment over to Long B. Pretty common. I like this boost play. Gonna get Revy up over top of this one. Smoke comes out. That's not gonna block complete vision. He's gonna be able to spot Robo if he does decide to peek out behind the box. He's got the scope up. Just trying to stare down. Oh, but Robo spots it, finds him, takes him off the map. Now Furious is gonna try to go with that AWP and find the return frag, but nothing doing just yet. Peeking out from around the backside of that smoke. Robo's still over here by the stairs. Gonna get mollied out of position. Decides to push up. Actually, Fast is gonna find one before the double trade comes in. Mariucci and Nyx gonna be able to find one. Nyx with another one. As Dobry drops in the swing back towards the terrorist side, as Furious manages to trade out for Nyx and finds the follow up on a cyber focus again, rendered useless with the AWP. 7-2. It's another reset.
Yeah, and that reset is going to be so key to Croatia right now. They need to secure this round. I mean, we're going to be seeing a force spy actually coming out from Belarus trying to accomplish what we saw them do previously. You've got the AWP on CyberFocus and an M4 on Sashkin and Dobry. So, you know, potential for something to happen here is, look, Stoll only buys up the MAC-10, kind of expecting an eco round coming out here from the Belarusian side, which quickly they are going to have to discover is not the case. Revy's going to be peeking long here. CyberFocus does come off the better one there as he takes him down, and that's going to be a one-man advantage straight off the bat for the Belarusian side now. 4 versus 5 as things stand, and well, Croatia, they need to get back on top of things. Just sending NYX over towards A with that bomb and two other players by his side. They've got Stoll, who's going to be watching the rotates off from that B site. He's getting a lot of information for his team right now. CyberFocus has already rotated in over towards that A site. Fast is there within earshot as well. And well, CyberFocus could potentially start things off the right way here by getting an opening kill. He isn't able to find that shot just yet. Furious open things up over on the A site by taking down Robo, and it is going to be a 4-on-4 for the retake. For the side push. What am I on about?
Altaud's going to do some serious damage on the CyberFocus. He has to stay alive here, but Nyx is going to get the trade out on the Fast. Finally gets dropped by CyberFocus, but Mariucci to answer back. The last man standing is Dobry. He's fully flashed, trying to get the AWP and save it at this point, but look at this push through. I think that was Furious on the other side of that smoke. Pardon me, it was Stoll on the other side of that smoke with the MAC-10. Not able to line up the shot. Gets tagged up by that USP a little bit, but trying to hang on to the AWP for the next round. This is a crucial part of this matchup right here. 8-2 is going to be the scoreline. Croatia looking very dominant on Terrorist side Cobblestone.
Yeah,
it's not that they're doing anything all that special.
Did my voice just crack? Oh my god.
That
hasn't happened to me. Yeah.
It's absolutely sensational that Croatia's able to do this right now. The biggest part about this is they're not doing anything special, so.
It's super.
Executions are on point.
It is really important, like you say, that they do manage to hold on to that AWP. I mean, that force buy as well in the previous round means that Croatia should be able to take this to 2-9. They're very, very reliant right now on CyberFocus turning up with that AWP. And right now, I mean, he's been pretty absent, if you ask me. He hasn't been his usual champ. He hasn't been turning up to the party, as it were. And they're sending him over to go solo B, which actually might not be the best move here, as it does look like Croatia, they're going to be opting for an A push.
Yeah, and this is a little bit of a change of pace here out of the T side. They've typically been going towards that B bomb site, or at least putting a presence over there at the beginning of the rounds almost every single round. This time they're going to flash on through the double doors in mid. I call it double doors even though there's only one there, but Molotov out in the corner. Well, that's going to flush you out. They're going to peek aggressively behind this, and they're both going to die. Stole picking up two. Oh, Mikadin, don't cringe. Don't overuse that word. Go back to Reddit. Curious, though, going to be able to answer back. Dobry does pick up two USP frags, and CyberFocus with the salvaged AWP from the last round is going to be able to punish one. And look at this positioning from Dobry. He's going to push himself up on long A, and there's actually a player coming out around the corner. It's Mariucci. He could get punished from this position. Oh, man, it's a game of cat and mouse. Both of the terrorists are over here. Don't make noise, Dobry. Don't make any noise. You can potentially put a spanner in things here for the terrorist side. The patience. It's going to pay off. He's going to be able to find the opener. Doesn't manage to salvage the AK, but CyberFocus is there. Brilliant play from Dobry to lock that one down at long A.
Yeah, a lot of patience there, like you say, in order to carry that one through for them. And basically won them that round. Now it's going to go into the 12th round. 3-8 is the scoreline currently, and Belarus are looking to secure another one, take it to 4-8, and start to come back out on top of things.
Yeah, and that's a nice recovery. If they can actually win out this half and get 7 rounds, that would be a huge turnaround here for the Belarusian side. But still a lot of work left, and you can see the economy not looking so great on the terrorist side, but their executes have been pretty solid, pretty sound throughout. That nade just obliterates the two players that are up in the drop room right now. Revy and Nick's going to get chipped down 57 and 46 respectively for those two players. We'll have to see whether or not they can recover from this. Nice push from Furious, though, finds Dobry. They get the tree player as well. One more to beat in the site. Robo, turn around. What are you doing? You know exactly where they're coming from. Little lackadaisical here on the CT side defense and the B-bomb site. They're going to allow them to get out and get vision onto this B-bomb site. A little bit of a lackluster play coming out from the CTs of Belarus.
Yeah, no, this is very, very good for them. And, well, still does manage to pick up one. That bomb should be going down soon as he gets the second as well. And in the blink of an eye, it all falls on a CyberFocus. It was looking like Belarus could have made something happen out of the this round and the previous. But sadly, CyberFocus is going to fall. And that means it's going to go 3-9 in favor of Croatia. Croatia making a very, very good attempt at this. Currently sporting a 6-round lead. And we are going to be seeing a pause coming in for... I need to quickly see what's going on here, actually.
Pretty sure that's a Belarusian pause. They need to talk over what they're doing for these last three rounds because they're getting punished. That last round was nothing special. They went out from Broken Wall with absolutely no utility being thrown. They didn't throw a flash. They didn't throw a smoke. They didn't throw anything. They just sent out the P250, the lone pistolero on their team, and it was Furious, and he finds that opening kill. That's madness that he's able to find that opening kill. With basically no utility. I believe the player that he actually killed was a non-head armor player that was over in the drop room. So, I mean, how do you even allow that to happen on the Belarusian side? You have nobody watching the Broken Wall push. You should have somebody, at least maybe Chicken Coop, maybe by the stairs, maybe sitting back fountain, or back statue for that matter, whatever you guys typically call that. But they had nobody. Nobody watching for that. They had a guy up on tree. That's not how you defend the B-bomb site, boys and girls. That's not how you do it.
Yeah, no, definitely not. And that was a huge issue for them that basically led to that round being lost. And now looking at it, it is going to be a force buy coming in for the Belarusian side as they try to work some of that force buy magic that we have seen pay off for them in the past. But Croatia, they're looking to stay on top of things. Molotov is going to be heading out, so that's going to block off the drop down area here. And you've got four players over towards B, so B might not be the right call for the Croatian side right now, but they're going to be going for it anyway. But it looks like Fast looks to open things up and doesn't manage to make that shot connect. And well, if he does peek again, he should surely get traded here. There are a lot of Croatian players playing this close angle. Robo gets one, Fast gets taken down, Furious able to pick that up. And well, that plant is now going to be opened up. Robo falls as well. B site just being chopped in half here. And well, it's all going to fall in. Adobe left alive on site. He gets taken down. And now Cyberfolk is going to be the last hope for the Belarusian side as he comes in. Does pick up one, but the potential to get a few more as he is, you know, one of the big names on the Belarusian team. But he's just going to have to fall back and save and take this into the next round. And I think ideally he'd want to save it for the last round, as a matter of fact, which, you know, we are very, very fast approaching, and Croatia.
That's if he can even get away.
Yeah, yeah, they're chasing him down, and, you know, fully understand why. Their economy is looking very good. They're going to get the $800 bonus at the end. Revy picks him up, and that means he's going to go 3-10. Croatia looking incredibly strong now.
Yeah, and unless there's a big recovery from the Belarusian side, this is looking like it could potentially even be a 12-3 half. Croatia has just been very dominant on their terrorist side. Look at how intermittent, if our observer can hold up the tab key real fast, look at how intermittent it was. Three rounds one way, then one. Three rounds one, two rounds one, two rounds. It's just, you can't do that on the CT side. The economy does not favor you whatsoever. You've got more expensive rifles on the CT side. Your incendiary grenades cost $200 more than a Molotov. Like, it's everything stacks against you on the CT side. And if you can't get your economy stable, if you can't get your economy going and string rounds together, then you're going to get into this buy, lose, save situation. And that's where you see these three round strings come together from the Croatian side.
Yep, definitely. And well, once again, we are seeing Belarus, like you say, on an eco. And they are pretty much destined to lose this round by the looks of things. Judging by the four-man push out towards B, Robo does find one and gets it traded down by Mariucci. Don't get one of his own on the Cyberfocus. Fast is being a bit of a pest over at the site, but does finally get taken down. And it's all going to fall on a Dobry. One versus four. And the only player to fall for Croatia was Furious. So a fairly flawless round for them there. 3-11 is going to be the scoreline. And well, it's the last round of the first half, the 15th round. And it is going to be a rifle buy for both teams. Let's see if Belarus can at least make a good showing here and potentially come out on top.
Yeah, this is not looking good at all for them. They don't have the AWP in the hands of Cyberfocus. He's trying to do what he can, but he's sitting at 8 kills. Sashkin, again, it's reminiscent of Overpass. You got 5 kills on Fast, 5 kills on, or 3 kills on Sashkin. They're just not able to do anything to hold this back. Pete comes out, and that's just a testament right there to Belarus's problems. That should have been a 100% kill every time for Dobry. But he loses that battle, gets taken down. Robo's trying to make something happen, but he loses his life on a weapon switch. And it's just mistakes across the board. Nice shot for Fast, but it's too little too late. The damage has been done. Furious goes in on Sashkin. He's going to finish this half 3-14. Robo trying to push the smoke, able to catch out one, but it's still a 2-on-1. And that player, Furious, is just hiding, hunkered down in the corner. It's a 12-3 halftime score. Croatia with a tremendous T side. And unless Belarus can pull their head out of their asses, they're going to drop this series and be out of this qualifier.
Yeah, definitely. And as well as that, I mean, if Belarus had won that round, it at least gives them a buffer between arriving at map point, even if they don't win the pistol. That's the key thing, right? Is if it had gone 4-11 and then Croatia win the pistol round and then they win the subsequent three rounds with it, you know, it only goes to 14-4, which, you know, not ideal, but at least you have got that tiny little buffer. Whereas now, if Croatia managed to secure the pistol round and Belarus don't get a plant in, that's it. You're a map point and you have to force buy. And if you force buy and you lose, then that's it. You're done. Like, GG, no re, go home to your families because you screwed it. And yeah, so it's not good. But anyway, we are going into the 16th round. First round of the first half, Belarus starting things off very strong. Robo getting a double kill there. So that's the pace that they needed. That's the momentum. And well, it's all going to fall onto Stoll, Mariucci, and Nyx to try and hold on to this. Bomb, though, is still over towards that mid area. And well, Mariucci, he's basically stuck between a rock and a hard place here. He's got players coming in from behind, players ahead, and he's got to try and do all he can to stay alive. Robo's going to complete things with a third, looking for the fourth, and he gets the fourth as well. And it is going to go 4-12. So a good first round from the Belarusian side. But I mean, still, I mean, they're relying on Robo so much. He got four of the five kills that round. And it feels like whenever they do win, it has to be down to Robo in order to make it happen.
Yeah, he's been the standout player for the Belarusian side. I mean, he was the top fragger on Overpass. He was in the mix. He really stepped up when they got to the CT side of Dust 2. Having a couple of tremendous rounds from that Accord. And again, I mean, into the pistol round here, saving the day for the Belarusians that he's able to pick up four going in through that. So they live to fight another day. It's going to be an investment from Croatia, and they've got to be careful. I mean, there's really only one player playing on this B-bomb site. A second one's kind of coming in, creeping a little bit. Flashbang goes out for Revy to be able to peek, but I think that actually blinded him a little bit.
Yeah, it fully blinded Revy.
Yeah, so it's a little bit difficult here. They're gambling over towards the A-bomb site on the CT side. They've got one player down through the bottom of the pit. That's going to be your number 8 man, Mariucci. And actually, a smoke comes out. He's going to Stewie 2K that. It's one player fully flashed, but there's a second one there that's not blind. But now they can rotate wholeheartedly in towards that A-bomb site, even though the rotation is coming back over towards B.
Yeah, I mean, they've got the one-man advantage. Wherever they go, they should be fairly golden. I think the point is now is they're basically faking it out because they made it look like it was going to be A. Now they're heading over towards B. Like you did so rightfully point out, it's going to come down to Revy here with the Deagle on site to try and do all he can. He's going to get taken down. Dobry securing a double kill there. And now it's going to fall into Stoll and Nyx to try and hold on to this as they both rotate on through the connector area and head off to go save. So not looking good for them. Nyx does find one on a fast. But, you know, just a consolation frag. Isn't really able to take much away from that. Doesn't get the SMG. Only the frag, really, for him there. And Belarus, not really too desperate to go hunting for this. I don't think they want to lose too many SMGs more than they have to. Especially when you're up against Stolen Nyx with these Deagles at close range. Saying that, Backlink is going to be able to pick one up over towards Zong. That's going to be still going down. Nyx managing to secure a second. Is finally going to get taken down by Dobry. So 3k for him there. That's a nice bit of a, you know, pound in his pocket. And it's going to go 5-12 with an eco round for Croatia now. So, we should see it go to 6-12, providing Croatia don't do something really crazy. And at that point, Belarus, I mean, they're still in this. And they're making it very obvious they're still in this. Especially when you consider that we saw Croatia. They don't have the best CT side.
Nobody understands that reference, dude. A pound in the pocket.
Oh, yeah?
Come on, man. What, did he get 600 quid out of that round?
Yeah, 600 quid.
Pushing on forward, though, another fast round. It's four SMGs on the board here. It's a really goofy-looking round here. All five of the CTs are over in mid, and they allow them to run all the way by. One player might get caught out here in the danger room. I believe that's the number 9 man. Yeah, Revy's just hiding down, hunkered behind the stairs, looking for a knife, potentially? Oh, yeah. Feels good, bro. Robo gonna be able to find the return frag, but the AK gets salvaged again. Mariucci with the USP is gonna be able to find one. That knife kill gonna be very, very strong. Mariucci doing even more damage. A Dink comes out here onto fast. He's down to 39. Still doable here for the CTs. They're gonna push on behind this. They do lose the AK in the long run, but a lot of damage being dealt.
Yeah, I mean, it was good they did the damage, because when you look at Belarus's economy, it was getting to a point where it was going to get out of hand. So the fact they took three guns away from them there is definitely good for the Croatian side. And going into this first rifle round, it's now that Croatia have to be, have to put a stop to the rampage that has been Belarus in the second half. They have to win this if they stand any chance of slowing them down, because if they lose, you let Belarus's economy get completely out of control and are also forced onto an eco round. And at that point, it goes to 8-12 and things look like it could all come up Belarus. So, you know, they need to win this if they want to, you know, continue the momentum, and they want to be able to secure, the map point and eventually go on a win. I do feel like this is probably one of the more crucial rounds in the game right now, for that matter. And looking at the layout, you've got three players over towards B, one playing passive over towards A. That's going to be stolen, I believe, and then pushed all the way up on long. You've got Mariucci. He was going for the information peak, isn't able to find anyone, so he's just going to fall back on the site. You've got four players for the Belarusian side over towards B. So a fairly good call being quite passive here. And Stoll playing that connector area does, of course, mean he can rotate between either site nice and quickly.
Molly to the back of B platform actually forces Revy out of position. So he was looking for that AWP shot, but now it's going to be Furious down by Broken Wall. Very slow strat from Belarus. They're not going for any extra aggression, but they've given up drop room. They're trying to take this long angle on it. But they've also given up back plat control. They've got an AWPer in sight that's going to be Revy just waiting for the peek around the box. And there's the shot. Dobry and drop room going to be able to find one. Sashkin going to go in on one as well. It's a little bit back and forth right now. This AWP causing so much havoc right here. Furious going to be able to find another one on the Cyber Focus, dropping the bomb carrier. And the big flank comes out. Upshot gonna miss. Second one gonna miss. The last man standing back to Fountain. Looking for this one. Another offshot misses. Another offshot misses. General Whiffington the third over here in Revy finds the two crucial openers. Somehow survives with 14 HP, and it's a 13th round for Croatia. And that is a very solid hold on the first gun round coming out from the CT side.
Yeah, but I mean, just then, you saw like case in point, the issue with Revy on the Croatian side is when he's having, you know, when he's landing those shots and he's making it work, he's very, very strong. His positioning and everything, very good. He did land those really nice two killers, but then he gets into this kind of state where he just starts whiffing. You know, you can't help it. He just misses every shot possible. Like, the target could be, you know, the broadside of a barn door, and he's still struggling. But anyway, Cyberpunk is going to start things off well for the Belarusian side, finding that one in Mariachi nice and early on in this round. And that does open things up into a 4-on-4. Actually, now Stoll equalizes out these numbers with a nice trade kill on a Robo down in mid. That's going to remove a lot of presence here. Revy going for this peek. Don't agree with it, really, unless he can find cover here. But I mean, Fast is boosted up, peeking on over. So potential for Revy to go down over towards Long, which would open up that B platform and allow the Belarusian side an avenue of approach as they do slowly start to make their way in.
Nice shot there from CyberFocus to open things up. Takes the battle against Revy and wins it. The lineup there, not going to be able to line them up and get both of those kills. And Nick's going to drop. And it's a nice round here from Belarus. And this is a potential for a reset on the CT side. So this gives Belarus a little bit more breathing room. They're going to get the 7, potentially 8 rounds out of this. And start to track down Croatia. Start to dwindle that lead that they have. And that's a pretty solid testament to their fortitude right here. Because they're not down and out just yet. They're going to continue to be able to battle back.
Yeah, I mean, the resilience that Belarus have demonstrated is actually fairly good on the grand scheme of things. I mean, Croatia, definitely a team that suffer from falling behind, the emotional impact. Belarus have shown that, you know, they're not prone to that. I mean, right now, 6-13, going into this is what started off as a 3-12 round. They've managed to get... it was 3-12, wasn't it? So now they've managed to secure 4 and only allow Croatia to pick up the 1, so... A really, really good start to the second half from Belarus, just demonstrating that, you know, Belarusian resilience, I suppose you'd say, in the face of defeat. And it is paying off for them. They're definitely putting the hurt on Croatia. Croatia down to an eco. Now they've got those two rifles. So unless Furious and Stoll can, you know, make something good happen with that, then potential for Belarus to take this to 8-13.
Don't count out those two rifles, though. Stoll and Fury is going to be trying to put those to work over at the B-bomb site. It's a very telegraphed push here from the terrorist side. Opening frags go out. Furious, 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's all gone awry. He's going to be looking for the ace on this one. Spamming furiously through that smoke, no pun intended. It's going to be CyberFocus to answer back with one. Finds the second one himself, looking for the flank play to come out. Not showing himself just yet is Mariucci, who is in the backside of those B hallways. A lot of work left here for CyberFocus. And there's the peek out, untimely as it ever was. Nick's going to be able to find that, and it's a hero play from Furious, lining them up at Brokenwald while they're distracted on that back plat player, and it's a beautiful ruse.
Yeah, I mean, just a wonderful play there from Furious to secure that 4K and a wonderful spray down. Like I was saying, that should have gone the way of Belarus, and I did say it would require the rifle players to really show up, and Furious does that in spectacular fashion. Good try from CyberFocus, though, and he looks to get revenge. So he does take down Revy in mid. That's going to put into a 4-5 early on, and Belarus, they want to hold on to this now. They're not playing for the draw. They've gone for the full buy, and well, let's see if that will come back to bite them in the arse as we do continue into the 22nd round, and of course, Croatia win this, it will be match point. So, I mean, it's really all to play for right now.
Really nice awareness there from Furious. He gets the jump on him, but the A bomb site, look at this. There's a player all the way pushed up on long A, but they've infiltrated in towards A, and Mariucci is going to get knocked down for that one. CyberFocus has got to be careful. That player's got his back. He's going to go down. So it's a 2-for-2 trade. That bomb hightailing it over towards mid, going to be trying to work its way up in towards the A bomb site, and they're going to look like for a second they were going to take the bomb over towards the danger stairs, but rightfully so, they don't. Full site control here for the terrorist side, but again, the X factor in this is Stoll, who's still holding from long A. There is one player that's down there in middle. It's going to be Dobry, watching for the murder hole push. Not going to see anything off the top of this one just yet, but that player does start to peek out. Doesn't spot him at the initial peek, but he does eventually get the headshot. The flashbang comes out, the spray goes out. It's going to be a trade now. Nice pop flash around the corner. Stoll's going to be able to find that, and it's all down to Robo, who does get spotted. Does manage to pick up the first one. Looking for the second one. It's going to be Stoll versus Robo in a 1 versus 1. Combined total of 53 HP, but there is a kid on Stoll. He's going to have to go for it, and Robo's going to steal it away. A 3K for him on the round, and he salvages a rifle out of it as well. An upgrade from the Galil, and another round on the board for Belarus.
Yep, 8-14 is going to be close indeed. And well, we do see Croatia put onto a, you know, not the most formidable we've seen them, sorry. It's going to be an eco coming out from them. You have a little bit of armor on Stolen Revy, but aside from that, not much across the board. Two of the players actually opting to stick with the vanilla pistols. Belarus, on the other hand, they're going into this with a fairly competent buy. Not much utility, though. At least not as much as we have seen them have. Usually, a push out long over towards B is going to be punished by Sashkin there as he picks up one onto Nyx. It's going to go 4-on-5, and that push should be underway over towards that B site any minute now. Revy does get one there for his troubles on the Sashkin. That's going to be the trade coming in that they did need a little bit earlier. It's going to go 3-on-4, and that bomb is still dropped over towards B with players down in mid. They are going to be facing off against Stoll fairly shortly. He has got that Deagle in hand. He might be able to start things off here with a wonderful shot on a Cyber Focus. And well, here we go. He will be hearing Dobry as well off to his left. And if he finds this kill, then he's going to be in a very good way. That's going to be bomb dropped over by Stoll now, and Fast is coming in from behind, trying to do all he can. He's got the UMP in the hand. He's also got Robo there to back him up. The rotate in from Marici is very, very slow, and well, it is going to punish them as Stoll gets taken down. Now Marici, realizing the error of his ways, does rush in, but it is going to be way, way too late. And I don't like how slowly he rotated there. How did you feel about that? Just, you know, we have a little bit of a lull between the action.
Not a big fan of that myself either. They had bomb control at the bottom side of mid. He just didn't know where the other player was. That's the big thing. And because of that, he was a little trepidatious on the rotation. I would have actually preferred to see Stoll fall back from that position and just give them back the bomb and then double team a site with his teammate. Still an opportunity into this one, but Mariucci is going to get aim punched to death and a 9th round for Belarus. They're still alive in this one, but Croatia, it's going to be another save for them. They don't have the money to formulate a full buy. They're going to put armor and the Deagle in the hands of Stoll, who was able to do work with it the last round. See if he can replicate that performance. But the big deal about that was, you know, you don't know where both of those players are. He had an avenue to escape in middle, or at least find himself a more passive angle rather than sitting in the doors there in mid. And he chose to fight as opposed to falling back and playing it a little bit safer. And it ended up costing him there. Stoll potentially could have really done a lot more work into that round.
Yeah, I do agree. Now we see Croatia force them to yet another eco. Nyx are going to start things off in a good way with the Deagle taking down Fast. Sashkin's there to get the trade, though. Does look for a second. Isn't able to find it. Stoll over towards Long, trying to put this Deagle to work, but we've seen him do things within the past, and he does. Cyber Focus goes down. Now it's going to go 3-on-3. And well, low HP on Robo here. Sashkin. Stoll is going to be the one to peek in. Robo finds that kill. It's going to go 2-on-3. Revy does have an M4 to use at his disposal. And Nyx does have the trusty Deagle. We've seen him land quite a few headshots with in the past. Over towards Long, though, Revy's playing this close angle, and it's all down to whether or not he gets checked, because if no one checks that, then he could be a huge thorn in their sides right now as that bomb is slowly making its way over towards the B site.
And again, it's just going to be another brawl over here right now as the trade's going back and forth, but it's coming out on top for the terrorist side, and it's going to be Nyx with this Desert Eagle playing behind Rock. He hasn't been spotted just yet. Finally does in Dobry. He's going to be able to tap him down. Another round for Belarus. Back within four. It's going to be a full-fledged buy here from the CT side, but it's Croatia to call a timeout. They're going to think about what they want to do going into this very, very important gun round, because they're in the same situation now that Belarus was in the first half, where they're in this buy-lose-save scenario, where if they drop this round, they might have enough money to force into the round afterwards, but they're looking at, you know, a 12-14, then possibly a 13-14, or even a 14-14 scoreline if they don't manage their money correctly. So this is a very, very crucial round. This might be the most important round of the entire match right here.
Yeah, definitely. Not only does it set the tone economically and pace-wise, but it also sets the tone emotionally for the Croatian side. I mean, they're going to be pretty defeated and tilted if they do manage to sacrifice this round. And, well, let's see if that pause there did come up trumps for them, as three players heading over towards B, two over towards Long, and a nice setup here coming out from the Croatian side. You have two players playing passively in mid, but not giving up too much mid presence. And then you've got the three over here, Furious, the trade. If Revy does get taken down, Revy playing the closer Fountain Angle with that AWP as well. They're not going aggressive, which I do like, because quite often we've seen Revy get taken down over at that plat area by Cyber Focus early on in the round. So it's good, of course, that they are just going to be falling back, opting to play these passive angles, and well, let's see if that pays off for them.
Yes, indeed. Again, Furious over by Broken Wall. He was so crucial for them in that last round that they won on that quasi-buy with the two saved rifles. Again, it's going to all come down to timing on this one. The bomb slowly creeping over towards that B-bomb site. Drop control completely open for the taking right now, as Nyx is on a very passive angle in that area. Smoke goes out so they can get some clairvoyance over towards the window to drop out from the drop room if they decide that they want to go in that avenue. Robo, again, was over at mid at the beginning of the round trying to harass a little bit, but we see the frags coming in. It's going to be Furious to open things up. Fast is there for the retort, but it's going to be Dobry to find the equalizer. It's Revy from Chicken Coops. He's doing a lot of work for his team right now. He just needs to stay alive. He needs to delay and allow his teammates to get on this flank, and that's exactly what's going to happen here. It's all down to this last man standing, and Revy is going to come out on top. It's a 15th for Croatia. They're one round away from taking the series.
Yeah, one round away, and what a series it's been. It's been so back and forth, and we've seen both teams playing so well. And well, it all comes down to this match point for Croatia here, with the potential for them to make it through to the second round of qualifiers. Let's see if that is what's going to happen here. It's going to be a four spy as well for Belarus, so not looking good for them straight off the bat. And well, a very aggressive mid play, a lot of change of pace that we haven't really seen from them in the past. Mariachi does find one with that main death. Trade does come in from Robo and Fast though to equalize things, to put things into a one-man advantage for them. Revy though, in with that trade frag, puts into a 3-on-3. Dole trying to do the damage in mid with that pistol, is unable to do so, but is denying a lot of mid presence there. Robo all the way up long is going to get hurt by Stolen. He manages to pick him up with the P250 because of the lack of head armor. And well, now it's going to fall into a 2-on-3 here. Cyber Focus gets dropped over towards long, bombs down as well. And well, it's all looking like it could be all over here as Dobry finds himself with a 1-on-3. He has to go and recover that bomb somehow as well. He picks up one on a Revy. And well, instead of heading over towards the bomb, Stoll's actually opting to stay here over towards the A side, and he picks him up. That's going to be Dobry going down, and it's going to finish off this series 16-10, 2-1 in favor of Croatia there. So, you know, to go ahead and break that down and talk about the series so far, as well as what we can expect from the matches tomorrow, we are going to go live one last time to the studio with our wonderfully talented and impeccably dressed, may I say, analyst desk.
Croatia is in the qualifying round too. Managed to win the third map, the decider in Cobblestone, against Belarus 16-10. They had probably a lot of luck, and I hope that's all the luck they will get when it comes to sports this evening. Moving on to Svojic and Svojic Zapin. I needed to do that. I so much. Yeah. Yep. Svojic, yeah, your thoughts on the map? Croatia looked strong.
Yeah, I'm really glad Croatia won. I didn't think they can do it, but it was basically copy-paste from last two, but with the reverse sides. Croatia was able to do whatever they wanted on that T side. Won the half like 12-3, right?
11-4, I think.
11-4. And at that point, it was pretty much, you know...
clear.
Clear, yeah, who's going to take it. But I got to say, Croatia gave away a bit of a... opening to Belarus with that second round force buy. I was like, why would you force buy? I mean, it's kind of in a way it's counterintuitive because you're leading so much, so like, you know, you're like, okay, let's force buy. But then again, you're leading so much and there's no need to take that risk.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, of course, force buy win rounds happen, and they happen a lot in CS:GO, as we mentioned, that pistols are overpowered. But then again, I think that's a risk. And at the 11-4 lead, at that point 11-5, because Belarusia won the second pistol round, I don't think that's the risk you need to take. And that pretty much enabled Belarusia to, at one point, be there, you know, fighting for the win on the Cobblestone. But overall, Croatia winning it, and congrats to our neighbors.
It backfired to Belarus that they didn't come in the strongest lineup.
Yep, they maybe could have switched players if they wanted to for that last map, as we saw in Turkey against Ireland. But I'm really surprised how good Croatia played that Cobblestone on their T side. I said the Giants loved to play that Cobblestone, apparently they still love to play it. They really had a strong T side, and I think a couple of rounds they took it purely with individual plays. Like they had, for example, I think we have a replay of one round basically with RB.
Go ahead.
RB Furious goes from platform B with one flash, I think, from his teammates and kills. He didn't even get flashed. So he kills one guy, Stoli kills another, and yeah, he whiffs his shot here, but immediately Robo gets away. But he really has like good spot. I think I don't think who was in. I think Revy misplaced his Molotov and he threw, he wanted to bounce off the Molotov of the wall and to the rock, but he kind of Molotov himself out of that position. And we see here after that post plant position, Stoli gets two really nice spray downs from that chicken coop and CyberFocus 1-4. And that was basically the round you said, like they lost, no, you didn't mention, they lost one round. They kind of forced by Belarus forced bot and killed I think Dobry killed two guys with USP only on mid, and after that they managed to get this win and this round, and that was basically like Stoli getting triple kill, Ivy Furious getting a really nice headshot coming out of that broken wall. So overall really nice play. I said I'll cheer for neighbors and I believed in them at this map, so congrats really for moving to
Congrats, Kalka around definitely. Switch.
Yeah, it's funny you mentioned you know, substitutes, because we said that Dobry, he didn't play well on Dust 2, he didn't play well on
Overpass.
It was a long time ago.
I know, everything mixed up today.
But actually he was their best player going into that city side. Yeah, the city side was poor, but I think he was like 10 rounds in, he was the only one with double digits. So there you go. Maybe he needed some space, some time to
pat on the back. Yeah, like way to go, way to go.
Yeah. But I also have one replay. Where I think that
awesome.
At that point, Belarusia lost it because, as you can see, yeah, they're gonna win three rounds after this. But before this round, Croatia won one, then lost one, and at that point, I'm pretty sure everyone who plays CS:GO, you know that your opponent is. Has a broken economy, and what they do, they go through a smoke and stack four guys and go to through a smoke, and as you can see here, RB Furious, he's gonna get the quad kill, but if he didn't get it, his teammate who had a pistol would have got at least one or two. So I mean, I just want to point out how horrible idea this was for Belarus, because I don't know why would you do that when you know, yeah, they saved a couple of guns. They saved two or three guns in the round they lost Croatia, but I mean, why, when you know they're going to have at least one pistol, why would you do that? They lost it. I mean, that's a correct punishment for a play like that.
Yeah. I think that, do you have some other replay or something prepared for us?
No.
Okay. Well, thank you for your help today. Thank you for your insights.
Thank you too.
Yeah. See you tomorrow.
No.
No? Well, some of you, yes. Some of you, yes. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, a quick recap of the day. Turkey versus Ireland 2-1. Turkey advancing to the second stage of the European qualifying qualifiers, as well as Croatia winning against Belarus. Thank you for watching eFrag TV. My name is Georgi Georgiev. Have a good night.